irreversible. So we must think before wasting it. All of us know time once gone, never be back. There are only 24 hours in a day. Everybody has to finish your work within that. Time management gives us the scope of good opportunities. The famous proverb shows the importance of time is time and tide wait for none. Thank you, ma'am.
Hi, my name is M.S. Aravind. I am studying in 3rd standard B section, Amalar Pavan High Secondary School. Now I am going to say about unity and diversity. Our world is very interesting because there is variety in our surrounding. This variety is called diversity. Diversity is the state of being different from one another. India is wide geographical diversity. We classify these differences into physical differences, social and economic differences. What is physical differences? Look different from one another. Many are from different states. Many are speak different languages, follow different religions, and so on. Worship differently, celebrate different festivals. In spite of all, we stay together and share with each other. What is social and economic differences? The social differences is largely due to caste system. The constitution of our country prohibits discrimination on the basis of caste. Differences in income lead to inequality and affects the people in many ways. Diversity is an integral part of our life. Diversity teaches us to be tolerant and respect peoples. The feeling of oneness is so strong in our nation that despite of all this so many diversities, India is rightly referred to as the land of unity in diversity. Thank you.
Good morning to everyone. I am Roshan Kumar, 3rd standard B section. I am going to give a speech on unity in diversity. India is considered to be the oldest civilization in the world. It is the home of 1.4 billion peoples. There are almost 10,650 different languages are spoken in the world. In India, there are 22 languages are spoken. The people follow different religions, cultures and languages. There are many communities, difference in India, like Malayalis, Gujaratis, Bengalis, etc. But all are united together as Indians in a social sense of unity among each other despite the difference in caste, creed and religions and also languages. Uniting in diversity is very important for our country. The term uniting in diversity relates the people of India live together with love and peace. Uniting in diversity helps growth to and development for our nation. We live together. We are Indians. I love my country, India. Jai Hind. Thank you.
Good morning to all. My name is Caroline Ryan. I am from 4th year. I am going to say unity in diversity. I love my country, India, which believes in the concept of unity in diversity. In our country, we welcome languages, religions, and people from different regions. There are a total of 6 religions present in India. They are Hinduism, Islam, Christianity, Sikhism, Buddhism, and Jainism. All of these religions may not be followed by equal number of people, but they all are respected equal. There are different festivals in different religions. During the time of festivals, all the people of different religions, cultures, and many more celebrate together. This unity among all the people in this country shows our strength and our richness in cultures. Being united as one nation, we are divided in 29 states. But we use the same currency everywhere in our country. A common of language, Hindi, is spoken among all the people of the country, even from Indian Air Force. The soldiers are selected from different religions, cultures, and languages, but they fight together and protect us from our enemies. The presence of such vast number of cultures, languages, and religions prove the unity in diversity. Jai Hind! Thank you!
My name is Mai Joseph Patrick. I'm studying in 4th standard section. The topic is unity in diversity. India is a country of vast diversity. It is the 7th largest country and second most populated country in the world. India is a great country. We people of different religions and cultures live in different regions. They live in harmony. India does not have one but many traditions. Although the Hindu religion is the oldest religion, but the other religions also enjoy full freedom and respect. The phrase "unity in diversity" was given by a first prime minister, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. India has been ruled by the Mughals and the English for centuries. But even the foreign rulers have not been able to destroy the Indian traditions and cultures. India has a diverse list of spoken languages, at least 800 languages, 2000 dialects have been identified. Of these, 22 languages have been recognized by the government. They are Assamese, Bengali, Bodo, Dogri, Gujarati, Hindi, Kannada, Kashmiri, Konkani, Marathi, Maithili, Malayalam, Manipuri, Nepali, Odia, Punjabi, Sanskrit, Santali, Sindhi, Tamil, Telugu, and Urdu. We may have different religions, different languages, different color skin, but we all belong to one human race. There is unity in every corner of India. This is our strength. United we stand, divided we fall. Let's be united forever. Thank you. Vande Mataram.
Good morning to all my respected elders. I am Lisha Sri from 4th C Amlopam High Secondary School. Allow me to present a speech on the topic Unity in Diversity. It gives in immense joy and pressure to say that India is a country that is a one and only example of the phrase unity in diversity, and I feel very proud to be one of the citizen in my country India. The phrase unity in diversity means remaining united even after living separately. In India, all the regions, cultures, different ethnicities are welcomed equally with proper respect. All the festivals of different regions in India are celebrated by everyone irrespective of their individual religions. We all are very powerful and united like a huge joint family who battles and problem together and remain united. We carry the symbol of peace despite being different from one another to regions religions, ethnicities and cultures. We have the soldiers in our army, navy and earth fort project from all over India. They all protect us from those who wish to harm us. We handle all the problems like together like a team. We all stand in a united manner. When our national anthem is played or sung to pay respect to our country, we remain in diverse places but still we stand united as one nation. We intend to go and represent our cultures and their unity despite being different among each other. In a perfect example of India is a perfect example of achieving growth with unity in diversity. It has big diversity in language, which is around 22 languages, but any kind of difference never became a hindrance to the development of a country. This is clearly visible when we compare today's development with development at the time in independence. So I end my speech here with the last point that India is like a mother and we are all the children of her, and therefore unity in diversity is must to develop a country. Thank you.
Together. Unity has an day to all. I am Ms. Rajalakshmi from 5th B. My register number is 13201586661. First, I would like to thank our senior principal, teachers and other staffs for giving me this opportunity to talk about United We Stand, Divided We Fall. Unity is of great value in every aspect of our life. It is the basis of society and nationhood. Unity is required all over. It strengthens the will to achieve our goals. Our body is like a machine with various systems working together, ensuring a happy and healthy life. First, I would like to state you an example, a bundle of sticks. We can easily break a single stick, but we cannot break a bundle. From this, what do we learn? Yes, you are right. Here comes the unity. Even history has an excellent example for unity. Mahatma Gandhiji, the great legend, paved the way for independence with the great tool, unity. United we stand, divided we fall, reveals the fact that if we support each other, whether it is a family, society or any organization, whatever it may be, we will reap success in our life. We students should join our hands together to carry the name of our school to the peak of success with flying colors. Teamwork makes the dream work. Thank you.
I am Arvind from 5th D in Anupama Secondary School. United we stand, divided we fall is the famous saying that everybody knows. We should always remember that our great nation has not survived these many long years by itself, but its people working together for the good of our country. Possibly having diversity in many aspects of our life, except one, that is our spirit. In simple, we call this as United we stand, divided we fall. Today, I got an opportunity to talk on the topic United we stand, divided we fall. A single stick can be broken easily, but for a bundle of sticks, it is very difficult or impossible. From this, we may know the importance of unity. I can do things whereas you cannot. You can do things whereas I cannot. But together, we can do great things. When bricks are put together, they become a house full of love and affection. The collection of stars in the sky comfort our eyes. The unity of people makes an immense but strong nation. So we have to be united. Let me ask a question to you all, my friend. Did God make all the fingers in the same length? No, God made every finger different from one another, so that they could work together to do their job. If we got all the fingers in the same length, it couldn't be possible to pick up a pencil. This proves us our differences or what enables us to conquer the impossible. Our greatest strength as human beings is to recognize our differences. But the greatest weakness as human beings is to accept and cherish them. A real strength lies in being united. A country is strong whose citizens are united. A family is strong whose members are together. Thus, unity is important for the each and every sphere of our life. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Good morning to one and all. My name is Sarini from 6th Standard C section. My register number is 13201492238. Now I am going to say the topic of United We Stand, Divided We Report, a gathering of individuals who remain united steadily makes more progress than a lonely individual. United we stand, divided we fall. It's a famous saying that are of note. This point they comprise that individual who stand. Solidarity was important in each period of our lives. We eat individual of its wealth, but in groups, if we work with teams, the rate of success is essentially higher. We humans are always dependent on plants for food, on land for shelter, and we are also dependent on other humans. Unity is important in every phase of our lives. The story of the old man and the three sons in Aesop fables is a great lesson to all of us. In the Panchatantra, we have a good lesson of a unity in which a ants man got some birds in a net. And old bird asked all the rest to unite their strength and fly with the net. The captured birds thus saved themselves. The story is a testimony to face that they were defeated by foreigners. Only when we ever divided among ourselves, when we stand together, we won back our nation. No matter how successful we become, we will always need people who can stand by us and support us. It is in the pillar and it also makes people considerate and understanding. It is also the basic foundation of our nation building. So stand united and build our nation. Thank you to one and all.
Good morning to all. I'm Yam Sivasti. I'm studying in 6th standard, 8th section. I'm going to talk about United We Stand, Divided We Fall. It is the most famous old saying word. If we work together, we can be successful. If we fight each other, we will be failed. Unity is always important for our family, country and society. The members of the family stay together and support each other in every phase of our life. Likewise, in sports, be it cricket, football or volleyball or any kind of sport, a united team make a strategy and results into success. A nation also becomes an economically strong if the countrymen support the government. Abraham Lincoln says, a house divided against itself cannot be stand. Helen Keller says, together we can do so much, alone we can do so little. Many leaders stand unity and fight for our independence. I'm going to tell a story of Pigeon Sunday Unity. One day in the jungle, a hunter saw a flock of pigeons on a tree. He quietly threw some nuts on the ground and then spread the net on the nuts. Soon one of the pigeons saw the nuts and dived to eat. The all pigeons also followed. After eating the nuts, when they tried to fly away, they found their feet was got trapped in the net. They was worried and started shouting for help. Suddenly, one pigeon had an idea and says, "When I count three, all of them should start flapping our wings and fly together with the net." The hunter, they were not sure and asked how this would help, and they agreed. The hunter who stands behind the tree laughed and come closer to the net. The hunter came closer, saw that pigeons. The clever pigeon said, 1, 2, 3, let's fly. All pigeons started flapping their wings together and soon they fly away. The hunter was shocked. he didn't catch any one of the pigeon and he lost his net. And getting far away, they come down to a helpful mouse. He cut the whole net easily. Now the pigeons were free. We all know human is a social animal. He cannot live alone. To understand this fact, we want and work successfully to our country. In this pandemic situation, we want also want to be the pigeons. Stay safe, stay home, and be happy. Thank you.
Hi, my name is M.S. Malamira. I am studying in 6th standard I section in Amlopam High Secondary School. Now I am going to give a speech about United we stand, divided we fall. Unity is of great value in every aspect of life. United we stand, divided we fall is a phrase used in many different kind of mottos to inspire unity and collaboration. Unity is one of the best nature in humanity. Several reasons don't allow people to stay united, such as discrimination, which takes various forms. It can be gender inequality, racism, or any other factor that forms gap between people. One stick can be broken, but a bundle of stick cannot be broken. A nation which is united is strong. A nation which is divided within itself is difficult to resist an enemy. One person alone cannot do everything. The internal misunderstanding, quarrels among the kings, made it possible for the Britishers to conquer our country by resisting divide and rule. They followed the policy of divide and rule and became successful. The best model is the Mahatma Gandhi joined all the residents together, having a place with various standing ideology and begin the peacefulness development. As nation is stable, whose residents are joined together. Since childhood, children learn various stories about integration. Even today, our elders tell us that we should be united and not to fight among each other. Unity visualizes resistance, love, regard and care for the different individuals from the network. But one thing should be remembered is that if we stay united, things will be easier to achieve and the feeling of togetherness gives us moral support and peaceful in tough times. Thank you.
Hello my dear friends and my dear teachers. My name is K.S. Pratiksha and I am studying in 6th grade. Today I am going to say about United we stand, divided we fall. United we stand, divided we fall implies that individuals who stand together are glad to accomplish a new objective throughout everyday life. However, separation can cause a great fall. Be it individual or expert, unity holds importance in each period of life. And if there exists unity among people, then chances of achieving goals will also increase. If there is conflict among them, their strength will decrease. Unity is the best nature of humanity. No single individual can perform what the gathering of individuals perform together. One person cannot perform all activities alone. He or she requires a team to achieve certain goals. Mahatma Gandhi, the great legend, joined all the residents of India with various ideologies and started the peaceful development. Moreover, in a diverse country like India, staying unified plays a significant role. It helps the state to achieve success in multiple fields. Nowadays, the modern world does not care what is happening in our environment and in our societies. If you really want to be united, be friendly, don't hurt anyone, talk to everyone politely, ask sorry if you have done any mistakes, and never cheat anyone. Sometimes even adults need to raise their thinking and move out from any discrimination to stay united and in tough situations. If we work together, we can be successful. If we fight each other, we will fail. Thus, I conclude my speech by saying, strength lies in harmony and disunity leads to conflict. The feeling of togetherness provides us moral support and peace in tough lives. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Pidvashri. Today, I am going to present a speech on unity in diversity. Unity in diversity means an interaction stand between many types of people. I am living in the society of unity and diversity. Unity and diversity enhances the equality of teamwork. Without unity and diversity, our life is just a hill. This phrase, unity and diversity, means remaining united even after living separately. All others like Mahatma Gandhi, Rabindranath Tagore, Bankim Chandra Chatterjee have different ideologies and different issues for which they stand for. So the term united in diversity coined by a great leader named Jawaharlal Nehru. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru is the first Prime Minister of India and the leader of Indian National Congress vigorously promoted united in diversity as an ideal essential to consolidation, national consolidation and progress. He wrote it in length on this topic by exploring it in detail in his work, The Discovery of India. In India, all cultures, religions, different ethnicities are welcomed equally with respect. We handle all the problems together like a team. We stand united with the national anthem song played or sung to pay respect to our country. India has different languages, different cultures and different religions. It is played because of diversity. Peace, harmony, togetherness, brotherhood are because of united in diversity. The great legend, father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhi said that our ability to reach unity will be the beauty and the test of our civilization. The Saint Teresa of Calcutta, the Nobel Prize winner, Mother Teresa said that our ability, only humanity will lead us to unity. Unity will lead us to peace. Thank you.
Good morning. I'm Yuvashree from 7P. Today, I'm going to talk about contribution of education. Education should be confined to books and everyone should get a chance to explore their knowledge and try something new. The time has changed and the mode of education should also be changed, and students should be given a chance to learn something new and exciting, and technology makes it possible. Role of technology in future education. In the coming future, even books will be available online, which will reduce the burden of bag of school-going children. The promotion of digital education will help saving the environment as well as will also help in decreasing pollution caused by the burning of unwanted materials. Education will become easy and accessible to every student. It will help students read, learn, understand, think, analyze, and then perform logically. Yes, it will help students learn, understand, think, analyze, and then perform logically. This will help in increasing the standards of education. Distance will never be an obstacle for students aspiring to gain knowledge with the help of technology. Technology helps us to perform advanced level research programs and learn new things. Technology rescues students from being uneducated for the year due to technology that had made children possible during COVID-19 crisis. There are multiple smart classes available everywhere, which increases students' interest and motivates them to learn and read. Technology is considered as a new subject of education because it is equally important. It has become a fundamental part of education. Nowadays, either you have to know your syllabus or you want to learn about a topic, everything is possible and available online. You can reach these resources with the help of various technologies. But in today's time, when technology has become an integral part of education, students quickly get multiple options to answer their questions. There are multiple platforms and apps where students can also ask their doubts or hear or have a live interaction with their teachers. Education has progressed a lot.
Hello everybody, I am Ishmari from 7th standard.
standard B section. I'm here to talk about the contribution of technology in education. Education is always important for everyone as it gives knowledge and respect for us in social life. On those days, teachers and students rely only on textbooks and library books for reference. But now, it has been widened. Internet e-books help children to explore their education. On those days, teachers use blackboards and chalks as their main material for teaching. But now, because of the invention of technology, many schools are using e-boards, projectors, computers, etc. for teaching. On seeing the contribution of technology in education, many apps are also included, like Byju's, Vedantu, etc. Particularly, in this pandemic time, because of COVID-19, all the schools and colleges were closed. But now, the contribution of technology in education has become inevitable. Students can study through seeing online classes, attending the online test, and receiving WhatsApp assignments from their schools. Technology also gives a big gift for children. That is, when seeing the online class, they can stop the video in the middle and they can note the points. They can also watch the video again and again for reference. They can also use it for their tests and exams. Technology is a games, videos and entertainment. This is a thought in everybody's mind. But technology is also a great contributor of education. If we use it for our need, it is a great contributor of education and it is a gift for us. But if we use it unwantedly, it is a bane for us. So, if technology is not now in the world, we should be sitting simply in the house and we are unable to get the education. So, we should be very thankful for this technology. Thank you for giving me this golden opportunity.
Hello all, I am Kabilan from 7th year. My register number is 131300036. I am going to talk about contribution of technology in education. Let me start my topic. We must understand that technology that not means games and watching videos, only it also provides us e-books, also called as electronic books. Learning session, important research data. We can use to interact with others. In this pandemic situation, due to COVID-19, technology comes as a rescue for us by making us to study online without going to schools. Nowadays, technology becomes an important component in our day-to-day life. There are people who may say children are spoiled by technology. Instead of being able to add a long term of numbers in their heads, for example, they turn to a calculator. Regardless of these arguments, technology is an important part of today's society. By assuming it into the classroom, students will be better equipped to transition from the classroom to the workplace. According to me, it is not that we use technology, we live technology. Education is the most powerful weapon that we can use to change the world. So, my dear friend, we as the
students
of Amolapuram Higher Secondary School must realize that the roots of education are bitter, but the fruit is sweet. Thank you, everyone.
My name is Kashika. I am from 7th Standard I section. I am going to talk about something interesting. Yes, contribution of technology in education. Introduction. The process of gaining knowledge is termed as educating ourselves. It is an endless process, but it is mostly used for students. Basically, there is no age for learning, but students and school-going children are more connected to this for education. when we take the help of technology for education, it becomes more interesting as well as convenient. Role of technology in present education. In the presence of technology enhances the level of education and makes it easier. Today, the easy access of internet had made education easy. It had increased the level. Nowadays, students don't want to wait for the teachers to complete a topic and they can easily read whatever they need online or with the help of educational apps or platforms. Nowadays, computers, laptops or mobile phones are easily available here to educate us. The use of technology is a boon for those who don't have much time, especially those who work. Suppose you work and you want to learn a new skill to improve or upgrade in your work, you can prefer an online course. In the COVID-19 epidemic, the schools were closed for more than 12 months and education was only possible online. Technology saved the students from being uneducated for 1 year. Really, thanks to the technology that education during COVID-19 got possible. There are smart classes available everywhere and this increased the students to encourage them to read. The role of technology in future education. Soon, books will be available in online and this will reduce the burden of the back of a school-going children. Digital education will be promoted and this will save the environment as well as will decrease the pollution caused by the burning of paper. Education will become easy and each and every student will get the same education. It helps the students to read, think, analyze and then perform. This will definitely increase the standards of education. Distance will never be an obstacle to gaining knowledge. With the help of technology, helps us to perform advanced research and learn something new. Conclusion. Education should not be confined up to books. One should get a chance to explore his knowledge and learn something new. Time has changed and the mode of education should also be changed. And a student should be given a chance to learn something new and interesting, and technology makes it possible. Thank you.
Morning, one and all. I'm Kavya from 7J. I'm here to discuss about an interesting essay, Contribution of Technology in Education. In this modern era, technology has become an essential factor in everybody's life. Every day comes new gadgets and software that make life a bit easier and improve exciting technology and software. The value of the technology sector is continuously and rapidly increasing. The more technology advances, the more benefit it provides to students and individuals at every stage of life. Technology has become an integral part of many curricula beyond computer and technology classes. Students using computer use the internet to present exams for learning from various educational websites and platforms. One of the main reasons to start using technology in classroom is because it makes education exciting and straightforward, resulting in better student learning experience. Technology has played a vital role in the field of education as it has created a digital platform for the students so that they can acquire more knowledge. Due to this update in the educational system, further school and college students are benefited in the relevant manner. Talking about its contribution, most of the schools and colleges have specially designed computer labs with very high teach facilities so that children can acquire new skills. Various computer language programs are also being taught to the children so that they get expressive in their field and it will help them in placement and job interviews. The major contribution of technology is the implementation of projectors in every classroom so that students can understand their subject easily, and also all the study material is made available to the students through online sources too. Technology has something a new subject of education because it is equally important. It has become an integral part of education. Nowadays, either you want to know your syllabus or want to clear a topic, everything is possible in online. You can reach these platforms with the help of various technologies. In olden days, students used to read from their book and if they faced any problem, they have to ask their teachers. But in today's era, when technology is a part of education, students easily get multiple options to solve their question. There are multiple platforms where they can also ask questions and they can have a live interaction with their teachers. Technology has made education easy and today we have more options to clear our doubts. Easy access and other helping apps made education easy as well as interesting. These gadgets also save our time. What we learned in Pressure, we never forgot. Hence, it is an important in every life. Thank you.
Greetings to one and all. I'm Priyadarshini of Class 7th J section. I'm here to talk about contribution of technology in education. Actually, there is no word to say about contribution of technology in education because it had contributed in a huge amount. It's play a vital role in a part of the education. Importantly, internet plays a major role in education. That is, if we search even a single word or a picture, we get immediate answer. So as we all know that this technology is useful during this pandemic period, as we use apps like Google Meet, Zoom Class, YouTube, WhatsApp. Such apps were used to writing assignment and test, reading, etc., etc. So the current situation is very good example for the contribution of technology in education. The contribution of technology in education is very fruitful during this situation. I'm very sure the contribution of technology in education will be get updated more and more in future. Thank you.
Happy morning, everyone. I am Anbu Chelvin from 8I. My register number is 131203337. Now I am going to talk about contribution of technology in education. Education and technology has become a major component in the system of education. Technology is such an intrinsic part of everyday life that it would be difficult to imagine society without it. Talking about its contribution, most of the schools and colleges have specially designed computer labs with very high-tech facilities so that children can acquire new skills. Even in my school, we have a computer lab. More than that, I am very happy to say that now we are provided with a new language lab in our school. Technology make teaching and learning more meaningful and fun. Technology has played a vital role in the field of education as it has created a digital platform for the students so that they can acquire more knowledge. In our school, we are provided with computers and big screens in each and every class, which is the major contribution of technology. In this pandemic period of crisis, we are getting education through technology. The softwares are used as supplement to the classroom curriculum. Programs provide study question, activities, even tests and quizzes for the class that help students learn outside the classroom. Students have better access to educational opportunities. Educational video games and system for young children helps them to prepare school and in some cases get a head start on their education. Does technology improve education? This is a big question that we need to answer. If it doesn't improve education, is it worth a try? The answer is affirmative. It improves education to an excellent extent. Let's be specific. How can technology improve education? When teachers are using technology effectively, it will engage students in the learning process. This was revealed by a study published in the British Journal of Educational Tech. Even in our school, our teachers are providing very good learning experience with smart classes. The study does not go neglect the importance of teacher. There are people who may say children are spoiled by technology. Instead of being added to a long column of number in their heads, for example, they turn to a calculator for simple calculations. Regardless of these arguments, technology is an important part of today's society. By incorporating it into the classroom, students will be better equipped to transition from the classroom to the workplace. Thank you, everyone.
Hello everybody, my name is Amal Faisha Barkat. I'm studying 8th standard A section. Now I'm going to share a few lines about contribution of technology in education. We are living in a current age. Technology has become an important component in our life. Every day there is some new gadgets or software that makes our lives easier and to improve the technology or software that makes already exist. Making life is not, however, the technology is the only role who plays in our life. Technology used in a classroom helps students to observe the material. For example, some people are visual learners. Projection screens are connected to a computers to allow students to see their notes, instead of simply learning a teacher what she deliver a lecture. Technology is playing in our role increasing in our education. As technology advances, it is used to students to all ages in the learning process. Software can be used to supplement class in the curriculum. The program provide us to study questions, activities and even tests and quizzes for a class that can help students to continue learning outside the classroom. Students also used to learn technology available to them in a computer and tech classes. This ensures that after graduation they will be able to use the technology in the working setting, which may put them ahead of someone who didn't have access to a particular technology or software in their own school setting. As technology advances, students have but better access to education opportunities like this. When something new and better is revealed, the older technology becomes more affordable, allowing it to be used in own their setting. And even schools are in tight budget. Technology has also advanced to help children even before they have started the school. Educational video games and systems are for young children. They are going to prepare for a school. In some cases, get a head start on the school. Thank you, ma'am, and have a nice day.
Good morning, respected our principal, junior members, teachers, and my dear friends. Today, my version of class 8th grade 301 Century Center has been provided the golden opportunity to deliver a speech on contribution of technology in education. Education is the most powerful weapon that we can change the world. It's been as a metadata. It is true, the ancient system of education was first in the Vedas, and therefore it was given the name of Vedic education system. In pandemic situation, we are in internet education system. My dear friends, the current age we are in, technology has become an important factor. Wow, every day comes new gadgets or software that makes life easier, enhance already existing technology. So only the more technology advances, the more benefits it provides to students at every level of education. My dears, do you know technology tools can help significantly reduce a teacher's workload by automating certain elements of their job? And once a teacher creates busy using technology, that material can be used again and again in later years. When teachers are using these technology effectively, it will engage students in the learning process. Technology is just a tool in terms of getting the kids working together and motivating them. The teacher is most important, said by Bill Gates. The study does not declare the importance of the teacher. In fact, researchers say that processes have more sophisticated ideas of teaching. Even though well-respected ones, technology is playing an increasing role in education. One of the best benefits of having a smartphone is that we can use our smartphones to learn by downloading some apps. Yes, apart from playing games and watching movies, we can use our smartphones to learn. There are many positive benefits of having smartphones, but only if we use them the right way. Today, the number one argument is that it is our job as educators to prepare students to become good citizens of the society we live in. We need to help create a better society and a stronger democracy. We need to be teaching our students how to navigate the digital world. We never know who is in our class, and by providing students with different tools to foster interests and talents, we might be creating the future scientists, app creators, filmmakers, actors, broadcast journalists, you name it, of our future. We need technology in every classroom and every student and teacher's hand because it is the pen and paper of our time. So how does technology support education? Easy, it makes it even better. There are numerous reasons why technology is such an important aspect of learning in schools. Whether we like it or not, technology is everywhere, and our students must know the technology to survive in their professional world. Thank you.
And my dear friends, I'm Shivani from 8th G. Today, I'm going to talk an interesting topic about the contribution of technology in education. Introduction. The word technology derives from a Greek word called technologia, where tech stands for art, craft, and skill, and logi stands for subject of interest. In the digital era which we currently live, technology plays a vital role. With each passing day, new software or gadget is being introduced in tech market that improves our lives in one way and another, make it much more comfortable. Technology is considered as a subject of education because it is equally important. It has fundamental part of education. Nowadays, either you want to know your syllabus or you want to learn a topic, but everything is possible and available through online. Education is progress a lot. You can compare marks in the old days where people used to get decision hardly, but nowadays it is not a big deal. The mode of education was never the same and it had changed continuously. Save time and energy. The contribution of technology in education. Now, present education. Nowadays, techs like laptops, computers and mobile phones are highly available and easy to use and help you to educate yourself. During this COVID-19 pandemic situation, schools were closed more than months and the only way of education is through online. Technology secured students from being uneducated for a year due to technology that made it possible during this COVID-19 pandemic situation. Nowadays, do you know there are multiple smart classes are available that make students increase their interest and motivate them to learn and read. I conclude my speech. Education should be a confined books. Every student should get a chance to explore their knowledge and do try something new. The time has changed and the mode of education should be changed, and every student should get a chance to learn something and examine the technology that made it possible. Thank you for giving this wonderful chance in this platform. And thank you once again, my dear ma'am and my dear friends.
Hello everyone, I am C. Varakumar of 8th Standard K section. My register number is 131201182. Now, I am going to give a speech on technology over education. In the digital era in which we currently live, technology plays a vital role. With each passing day, new software and gadget is being introduced in the tech market that improves our lives in one way or another and makes it much more comfortable and sophisticated. The mode of education was never the same and it has changed continuously. In the beginning, there were no books or notebooks. Students used to learn whatever their teacher used to teach in their classroom itself. But after the invention of paper and pen, slowly the process moved, and today we have the technology in our new mode of learning. Technology introduced in the classroom has made children understand and learn what they are being taught. The presence of technology maximizes the level of education and makes it a lot easier. Today, direct access to the internet has made education easy. It has upgraded the level as well. There were many optionables where more and more educational apps are there where we can read anywhere and everywhere. The use of technology is beneficial for those who don't have much time on a day-to-day basis, especially for those who work. Suppose a person wants to read or learn to upgrade his or her skill, he or she can opt an online course easily. Now, the technology in the education has made during the COVID-19 pandemic for more than 2 years while the schools have been closed. It has been also reduced the pollution of unwanted materials like carbon monoxide by the vehicles. Thank you for giving this wonderful opportunity to give me a speech on technology over education.
Hi, I am Sheikh Dawood. I am from 8K. My register number is 131201172. I am going to talk about contribution of technologies in education. In the world we currently live in, technology is a very vital factor. It has impacted almost every aspect of life today, and education is no exception. Technology is a powerful tool that can support and transform education in many ways. With internet and smart devices, a new age of anytime, anywhere education is dawning. Today, maximum amount of educational information like videos, audios are available at our fingertips through internet. The effective usage of digital learning tools can increase students' engagement, helps teachers to improve their lesson plans, and facilitate personalized learning. It can also build students' essential skills. With the help of virtual classrooms, audio, robots and other technology can create more inclusive learning environment. Online education is now accredited and changed the way we view education. The COVID-19 pandemic is quickly demonstrating that online education should be the vital part of teaching and learning. This is new and great experience for students to submit tests and assignments at online. Pandemic and lockdown can't stop us from learning. Thank you.
Welcome to all. I am B. Puvirsu from 8th K and my register number is 131-20-323. We are here to speak about the contribution of technology in education nowadays. Nowadays, we struggle a very lot of problems due to COVID-19 coronavirus. We are attending our online classes by phone technology. Nowadays, phone is a very important source for students, which is a very best contribution of technology. If technology isn't there, we may face many struggles and problems in our daily lives. We are getting important messages and assignments from our school through WhatsApp. And in our school itself, there are many electrical appliances like speaker, TVs, computers, lights, fans and RO purifier, etc. And through these technologies, we can know more knowledge and ideas, and we can clear many doubts. And in our book or printer, which are easy for us to carry them and to learn them. In these days, technology is a very, very important for the students nowadays. If there is no technology, there is no education today, and our future may be a question mark. Through this speech, we can find how important is the technology nowadays, and the contribution of technology is very, very important for the students who are getting educated now. Thank you for this golden opportunity.
Hello everyone, I'm Kanishka from 8th B. My topic is contribution of technology in education. The digital era in which we currently live, technology plays a vital role. With each passing day, a new software or gadget is being introduced in the tech market, which improves our lives in one way or another and makes it much more comfortable. The mode of education was never the same and has changed continuously. In the beginning, there were no books or notebooks. Students used to learn what their teacher teaches in the class itself. After invention of paper and pen, slowly the process moved. And today we have technology in a new mode of learning. Technology introduced in the classroom helps students to learn and understand what they are being taught. Technology is considered as a new subject of education because it is equally important. It has become a fundamental part of education. Nowadays, either you want to know a syllabus or want to learn a topic, everything is possible and available in online. You can reach these resources with the help of various technologies. But in today's time, when technology has become an integral part of education, students quickly get multiple options to answer their questions. There are multiple platforms and apps where students can also ask their questions or have a live interaction with their teachers. Education has progressed a lot. You can also compare the marks. In old days, people used to get distinction hardly, but nowadays it's not a big deal. Technology has made education readily available, and today we have numerous choices to clear our doubts. Easy access to the internet and helping resources has made education easy as well as enjoyable. These modern gadgets also save time and energy. Thank you.
Hi everyone, I am Adrian. I am from Medica. Today I am going to talk about a topic called technology contribution to education. Technology is considered as a new subject of education because it is equally important. It has become a fundamental part of education. Nowadays, neither your syllabus or want to learn about a topic. Everything is available and possible in online. You can use these resources with the help of various types of technology. But in today's time, technology has become an internal part of education. Students quickly get multiple options to answer their questions. There are multiple platforms and apps where you can ask your doubts and have a live interaction with your teachers. Technology has processed a lot. In the olden days, people get restriction hardly, but today, nowadays, it's not a big deal. Technology has made education really available, and today we have numerous choices to clear our doubts. Easy access to the internet and other helping resources has made education easy as well as enjoyable. The modern gadgets also save time and energy. I am going to finish my speech by telling a quote. Technology will not replace great teachers, but in the hands of their great teachers can be a transformational. By written by George Coates. Thank you for listening to my speech and thank you for giving me a great opportunity. Stay safe, stay home. Thank you.
Hello everybody, I am Aarti of 9B. My register number is 13110350. Now I'm going to talk about my fight against COVID-19. Across the globe, the spread of COVID-19 continues to cause disease, death and disruption. It has pushed even the most advanced health systems to the brink. The crude mortality ratio for COVID-19 is estimated to be upwards of 3%, but can change from country to country and even within countries. India is currently witnessing the second wave of the COVID-19 pandemic. India, being the second most populous country, India is affected by corona heavily. Our country recorded 295,041 new COVID cases on 20th April, pushing the caseload to 1.56 crore. The COVID-19 is spreading in our community. We have to stay safe by taking some simple precautions such as physical distancing, wearing a mask, keeping room well ventilated, avoiding crowds, cleaning your hands and coughing into a bent elbow or tissue. As we are being in Puducherry, we need not to be that much afraid because the spread of COVID-19 is less here. The population of Puducherry is estimatedly 8,056,354. The first fully vaccinated city in India is Bhubaneswar, the capital of Odisha. About 1/3 of population is vaccinated in Puducherry. So we have to follow those simple precautions and every citizen of India should be get vaccinated. We have to keep our environment clean, the most important thing. By being vaccinated and being safe, one can fight against harmful coronavirus. Thank you.
The nose when an infected person coughs or sneezes. So it is important that I also practice respiratory etiquette. For example, by coughing into an flexed elbow. Also, to prevent this pandemic period, the awareness campaigns and Aarogya Setu app are very useful and helpful for me. If we all follow these rules, we can minimize the spread and flatten the curve of infections. And then, in this pandemic period, to stay connected with our families and friends, the WhatsApp and Facebook group are very useful for me. I have spent my free time in watching TV, doing my schoolwork and my routine work. I have drawn many drawings in my home, and some neighborhoods in my street are having dance and sing-alongs from their doorsteps or out of their windows. Small acts of positivity and kindness can brighten everyone's day and help with our mental health. At last, I protect my immunity system by keeping myself healthy, such as taking care of my sleep, getting some daily movement even in self-isolation period, eating well, and intake the vitamin. I ate more fresh fruits and vegetables, which is in vitamin C, D and B12 by the advice of my family doctor. In this pandemic period, my father is getting less salary, even though he spent more money for our health with the help of bank loan also. All over this, because of my family and with the help of my friends, in my self-isolation period, I was very bold and encouraged to face that situation. And I was fully recovered from COVID-19. So, my dear friends, you also stay home and stay safe. Thank you.
Hello sir, good morning sir. I am Sabarish. I am studying in 9th H. My register number is 62018854. The topic that I am going to speak now is my fight against COVID-19. Coronavirus, which is commonly called COVID-19. It is an infectious disease. It is first identified during December 2019 in Wuhan city of China. The most symptoms are fever, cough, and shortness of breath. Social distancing is one of the best solutions to prevent COVID-19. Whenever I go outside for my school works or compulsory works, I will wear mask properly that covers my nose and mouth. When I come back home, I remember to wash my hands frequently with soap and water or alcohol-based hand rub. I will stay home if I feel unwell. I maintain a social distance for 2 to 3 meters. I will cover my cough or sneeze with a tissue. Then I will throw the tissue in the trash. I will clean disinfected frequently touched objects and surfaces using a regular household cleaning spray. It is our responsibility to keep our country safe from the virus, and we should all put vaccine because it gives the immunity to protect the COVID-19 from us. Thank you, sir, for giving me a golden opportunity.
To my respected teachers and my talented students. My name is K. Raghavi. I am from 9th B. My register number is 13110328. First, I thank you to give this wonderful opportunity to interact with you like this. First, I am going to talk about the coronavirus. Coronavirus is caused by a virus named SARS-CoV-2 virus, which is a contagious disease. It was first identified at Wuhan City. It was first identified at Wuhan city of China. The disease has spread worldwide, and WHO has announced it as an ongoing pandemic. As a result, many countries have announced lockdowns and night curfews. This lead to a serious social and economical impact on people on the world. Now I am here to talk about my fight against coronavirus. First of all, corona is a communicable disease which spread mainly through the air from an infected person. This affects lungs as well as trachea, which cause severe pneumonia and other respiratory diseases, and eventually leads to death. To avoid this, WHO has recommended to wear masks and face shields. People should clean their hands by washing their hands for at least 20 seconds. The people who are affected by the COVID-19 should be in quarantine compulsory for 14 days. Last week, peak cases were registered in Delhi and Mumbai due to the gathering of the people in fish markets and tea shops. People should make social or physical distancing should be maintained in the busy places like fish markets, tea shop, park, mall, gym, etc. COVID-19 vaccine is a vaccine intended to provide immunity against SARS-CoV-2 virus, which causes coronavirus. So far, 200 vaccines have been approved by the WHO. The vaccines that are used in India are Covaxin, Covishield, and Sputnik. There are many rumors about these vaccines in social media and internet. Don't believe these rumors until verified by the government of India. Maintain social distancing, wear mask and face shields, wash your hands using sanitizers to reduce the spread of this coronavirus. And let's make a healthy world and life. Once again, I am thanking you to give this wonderful opportunity to interact with you like this. Thank you.
Hi everyone, I am Kunishpa, I am 9th and I am going to share an important topic from this situation. So the wonderful topic is fight against COVID-19. This novel coronavirus was identified as the case of Chinese authorities on 7th January 2020. The fight against COVID-19, a couple months into the fight against COVID-19, India has seen a major popular that has legally put up a brave face, not only coping with the adversity as individuals but large headedly extending hand, helping hand to the lesser privileged in the community. The lockdown that came into effect on 25th March for 3 weeks has been implemented in phases. The third phase has been announced recently to extend over a 4 nights standing 4th May to ensure the minimal incidence of the pandemic. Together, the fight against COVID-19 and ensuring the essential health services are maintained in a vital role. We must not only reduce the mortality of COVID-19 itself, we must able to look after your mental health and be supportive to others. It is natural to feel sad, stress, compressed, cracked, serious, fearful. Coping strategies such as getting insufficient rest, exercise, eating well and avoid harmless substances, and staying in the close contact with your friends and families. Now is the time for unity. The COVID-19 pandemic is one of the most dangerous challenges in this world faced in our lifetime. It is above all a human series with the severe health and social economic consequences. Once we have finally turned the page on this pandemic, there must be I need to look back fully to understand how such a disease emerged and spread its demonstration so quickly across the globe. But it now is not the time now. Is the time for the united to work together in a solidarity to stop the virus and shattering its consequences. Stay home, maintaining social distances. Coronavirus is a group of related virus that causes disease in mammals and birds. Inhuman coronavirus causes respiratory tract infections. Protect yourself and others from infection by washing your hands and by alcohol-based rub frequently and not to touching the face. The COVID-19 virus spreads primarily through the droplets of saliva are discharged from the nose when an infected person coughs. So it is important that you are also practice respiratory at the equator. Here are some ways to prevent the spread of COVID-19. The COVID-19 virus spreads primarily through the droplets of saliva are discharged from the nose. When an infected person coughs, so it is important that you also practice the respiratory at the equator. Here are some ways to prevent the spread of COVID-19. Avoid touching surfaces, especially in public settings or health facilities in case of people infected with COVID-19. Have touched them clean surfaces irregularly with the standard disinfectants. I hope that everyone has a fulfilled mind along our novel diseases with this coronavirus. So we had to stay safe and eat healthy foods and maintain social distance. Let us be together and fight against COVID-19.
Pleasant morning to everybody. My name is Supriya and I am studying in 10th standard C section. Now I am going to talk about a topic that is my fight against corona. Corona is a pandemic disease which is also known as COVID-19. It has been first started in China in November 2019. Now it has spread all around the world. So how to fight against corona? That is, how to prevent from corona? My first point is, please wear mask. Mask is an important and essential thing during this corona period. I can see people that they are very perfect wearing mask, everything, but they are doing one mistake. That is, they are removing their mask and they're coughing. It is not the correct way to do that. For what reason we are wearing mask? We are wearing mask because to protect ourselves and we should not spread any disease to others. So please avoid that. And my second point is, please maintain distance and not be in a crowd place. A simple example that is happening in every Sundays, people are rushing in fish markets and mutton shops. We are not only buying fish or mutton, we are getting one free gift, that is 1+1 offer. We are getting a free gift, that is corona. So please avoid that. Please be in a queue. Please be in a queue and please keep a distance from one another. So please follow the government rules. And my third point is an important point about vaccination. People are very afraid to be vaccinated. That is, they are thinking that if we are vaccinated, we will be dead or we will be getting fever or some other. No, it's not at all true. But a simple example, that is, if a baby injected with a TT injection, she will be suffering from fever for 2 or 3 days. After 2 or 3 days, the baby will be all right. Like that only every vaccination also. Now, about 18 years are being getting vaccinated. So, soon our government will be instructed that below 17 years also will be vaccinated. So, please be vaccinated soon. And my last and final point is, please follow the government rules and do your regular routine. Thank you.
Good morning to my respectable teachers and the beloved students. My name is K. Rogi and I am from 10th year. My register number is 131-00349. Coronavirus is a deadly disease which is caused by a virus named SARS-CoV-2. It is a respiratory disease which affects the lungs and can eventually lead to death. To avoid the spread of the virus, the government of India has announced full lockdown and night curfew in all the states. Though the lockdown is in process, the coronavirus cases increases every day. This is due to the lack of certain safety regulations which should be followed by the people. Now I am here to talk about my fight against COVID-19. COVID-19 is a communicable disease which can spread to air from an infected person to a normal person. To avoid the infection, one must wear a protectable face mask and face shield. A survey recently taken in India states that 60% of the people does not wear mask, 30% of the people wear mask but not properly, and only 10% of the people wear the mask properly. This has led to the development of the second and the upcoming third wave of corona. As corona is an airborne disease, gathering should be prevented or social distancing should be maintained in places of gatherings like temple, park, gym, market areas, etc. We should always wash our hands for nearly 20 seconds to avoid the spread of the virus. Avoid touching your face and cover your mouth and nose while coughing or sneezing. Smoking and other such activities should be refrained as it weakens the lungs. Avoid eating junk or fast food and start to consume nutritional food to increase our immunity. The best effective way to protect yourself from coronavirus is to vaccinate yourself. Sputnik, Moderna, Covishield, Covaxin are the corona vaccines that are used by the government of India. These vaccines are harmless and increases our immunity against COVID-19. Last but not least, avoid spreading rumors regarding COVID-19 and about their vaccines. I am thanking you for giving this wonderful opportunity to me to express my opinions through this video. Thank you.
Good morning, teacher and everyone. I am Jivita. I am from 10th A and my register number is 2130601. Now I am going to speak about the topic, my fight against COVID-19. COVID-19 is also known as coronavirus, which was started in China in 2019 by December month, and it was spread all over the country by now. I am going to say some measures from which we can protect us from coronavirus. First measure is we should all stay home. If there is a 144 rule or not, we should not go out for unnecessary reasons. If they are putting 144 rule, we should obey that, and we should obey the rules which was allotted by the government. And the second thing is we should wear mask. Now we have gone across the second wave, so we should all, it is a very compulsory thing to wear mask, and now they are telling us to put double mask. So we should all obey that rule. And the third thing is we should all sanitize our hands, and we should all sanitize our things which we are getting out. Our purse, wallet, watches, keychains, and the vehicles which we are getting out, which is also must be sanitized. And we should all stay sanitized in our homes also. If we are not going out or not, it is not a thing. But we have to stay sanitized and we have to stay healthy. And the third thing is we should all get vaccinated. Vaccination is one of the major important thing. And vaccination is available by our nearby hospitals also. So the government is insisting us that we have to get vaccinated. So everyone think of that, and we have to get vaccinated. Vaccination is nothing but a injection which they will inject coronavirus. It has no power. For that, it can our memory cells can record that, and whenever we get a coronavirus, it has the memory of how to fight against the COVID-19 which is inside our body. So we should all get vaccinated, and we should all be sanitized, safe and home. Thank you all. Stay happy, stay safe and stay healthy. Thank you.
Hey everyone, this is Soumya from 11B Commerce Department. Today I'm going to speak about my future, my responsibility. Is my future my responsibility? The well-known answer to this question, as you would all agree, is yes. But why is my future my responsibility? Because I'm going to live it. As Charles Catalanic once said, my interest is in the future because I'm going to spend the rest of my life there. We are all interested in our future than our present. We all hope that our future will be better than our present. I am who I am. My life is according to my actions, decision and attitude. Every today is the result of action we done yesterday, and every tomorrow is the result of action we are doing now. Today I am speaking to you because of the action I done in the past. Since I am a student, my current responsibility is only to study. Is that so? Not at all. As our first Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru rightly said, the children of today will bring the India of tomorrow. The way we bring them up will determine the future of the country. So, teaching the values of life, discipline and culture can make them grow as responsible citizens. We are going to be the future generation of India. We are going to be the next group of people who will be able to vote, hold office and help our world. Be it a doctor or a lawyer or a sanitary helper or a cook. Every profession pays huge respect because everyone helps in the progress of our country's economy. Everyone works today so that they can give the best tomorrow. So act according to your responsibility. Let us all bring the best tomorrow to the future generation. Jai Hind.
My name is M. Roshan Silva. I am from 11th standard E section. My register number is 82018826. I am going to talk about my future and my responsibilities. I am who I am. My life is second to my decisions, actions, attributes and my attitude. At present, I am a person who is still in the process of self-actualization. I am currently learning from my experiences. I continuously grow for self-actualization. My experiences taught me lessons, which keeps me in my holistic development. With the constant changes and evolution in my life, I wish to be someone who is already self-aware in the future. I hope to find the best me, a better version of myself, someone who is confident enough, fulfilled enough, and stronger than before to conquer the realities in my life. Together with my hopes and wishes of self-actualization, I am well aware that I play a great responsibility in forming myself. As I explore to learn, I know that I need to be sensitive enough to know when I cross the borders of morality, immorality, and must determine the good decisions in my life. Moving forward, I know it's not going to be an easy task. Living is a complex job in this world. However, I can say it loudly and clearly that I am determined enough to conquer my life. May it be at my present and in the future. Thank you.
Hello everybody. Firstly, I would like to thank you for giving me this opportunity and it's my pleasure to introduce myself. I am Dhanalakshmi S. from 11F. My register number is 1309033. Life is not about finding yourself. Life is about creating yourself. With this famous quote by George Bernard Shaw, I'm here to speak about the topic, my future, my responsibility. Future is something that we can't predict. The future is not something that we should fear. Just because we can't predict it, instead we have to accept it and move on. As a student, I'm concerned about my future, scoring good in my board as well as my competitive examinations and landing into my dream job. If we scan through what is happening all around the world, we start worrying a lot about the future. The social values, human values are dropped to the floors, while terrorism, exploitation of nature, global warming, etc. are increasing alarmingly. Unless we plan to start living a peaceful and organized life with respect to social values and without working against the nature, the future prospect looks very miserable. We need to switch to organic living as quick as possible, and we should realize that we are responsible for everything, not only at home but also in the outside world. I want to build up my future, have a good career and live in a harmonious life with my friends and families. I keep believing in myself and my trust in God will help me to obtain all my desires and my plans in a good future. Being a student, let us aim high, plan well and work hard to reach our dream career. Along with that, we have a social responsibility. Let us work together to preserve the earth for the future generations. Living is a complex job in the beautiful world. However, I can say it loud and clear that I am determined enough to contour my life in my present and in the future. Remember that there is no wine if grapes are not pressed, no perfume if flowers are not crushed. So don't be afraid if there are pressures to in your life. It will bring you the best version out of you. Thank you, friends.
A very warm greetings to all of you watching this video. I am Hari Prashant of class 11 section C, here to talk about a very important topic, that is my future, my responsibility. I myself, being a very much future conscious person, found this topic attractive, but at the same time I also had a confusion about it. My future is my responsibility, what's there to talk about it? It's a universal truth, isn't it? But when I began to ponder over the topic, I was little shocked at the depth of it. So I am going to share my opinion regarding this topic, that is my future and my responsibility, with you all in this 2 minutes. If people don't think that they are responsible for the future, whom else do they trust? I too got the same doubt. So, number one, parents. Most of the people these days, especially Indian people, blindly trust that their parents are responsible for their future. We often used to tell the parents not to intervene in their child's future, like don't impose your decisions on them, let them act independently. But when we look from a parent's perspective, we may feel that whatever they are doing is correct. Because most of the parents, whenever they ask their child on what they are going to become in the future, these generation childs are literally wordless and they are highly irresponsible. This causes the parents to get panicked and intervene in their child's future. So both the children and parents must understand this. My parent can only advise me how not to slip in the future, but I cannot always expect my parents to come and lift me whenever I fall in the future. Second one, teachers. Most of the parents send their child to a best institution, they spend lot of money, and that's also not enough for them. They even send to the tuition centers, then they put even more money and send to the educational coaching centers. What they think is that if we send our child to a best teacher, then his future is secure. Let me ask a question to every one of them. How can a child's future be given to a teacher? My teacher can only guide me. Only if I am responsible personally, I can use the guidance in a proper way. So, as a responsible person, wherever I may be, if I am personally responsible and I care about my future, I can come up in the future. So, in my journey towards my future, my parent and teacher can only sit and guide me in my either side. But at the end of the day, it should be I who should responsibly drive the car towards my future. Number 3. Blame game. Do you know what's the difference between a real winner and a real loser? For instance, take me. Let's take that I'm participating in an examination and I fail in the examination. If I say like this, okay, I'm responsible for this mistake. In my future, I'll be even more responsible and correct my mistake. If I say like this, I'm a real winner. Instead, if I say like this, all the questions were out of portion. Yesterday, there was power cut in my home, so I couldn't read. That boy copied. That boy cheated. My teacher didn't teach me properly. My parent didn't put me in a good school. If I say all these things and try to put the blame on somebody, then I am an irresponsible, idiotic loser. So these days people try to put the blame on somebody and escape from their responsibility. So a blaming person can never be responsible of his future. And the last one is, you may find it funny and crazy, I too found the same way, is fate. Most of the people live life without any ambition, without any inspiration. They live life as life goes on because they believe in fate. They believe that God has already written their destiny on their forehead. They believe everything is predetermined. They don't do any work. They are not responsible at all. They think whatever we do, what is written in heaven will come. They believe in good luck and bad luck. To all those people, I'm saying one thing. See, I may not be a great philosopher with great wisdom, but while preparing for this elocution, I did learn a good truth, thanks to whoever chose this topic. See, this world will never see my backstory, my struggles, whoever were responsible in my life. It will see only my status, my position, how much I have succeeded. So it must be I who should be really caring, devoted and responsible for my future. This applies to all the living beings in this universe, including the animals. I hope you understood this. I hope you liked this also. Thank you. Don't forget. My future, my responsibility.
Good morning to everyone. I am Neeraj. I am studying 11th standard, E section, Namalapena High School. I am going to tell about my future, my responsibility. My life is according to my decision, action, attributes and attitude. At present, I am a person who is still in the process of self-actualization. I am currently learning from my experiments. I continuously grow for self-actualization. My experience taught me lessons which keep me in my holistic development. With the constant changes and evolution in my life, I wish With the constant changes and evolution in my life, I wish to be someone who is already self-aware in the future. In my future, I aspire to domesticate in this world, to view to my friends and inspire them to treat each other accordingly. I hope to my friends best of time, a better version of myself. Someone who is confident enough, full enough and stronger than before to conquer the relatives in life. Ultimately, my life is an intricate combination of past, present and future. At all times, my life is being affected by past experience, present situation and future aspiration. My past experience show how I react in the present situation, while my present experience influence the present situation that I take on. I play a great responsibility in forming myself. As I explore to learn, I know that I need to take full responsibility with my action. I need to be sensitive enough to win. When I cross between the borders of the morality and immorality, I must determine a good decision in my life. Moving forward, I know it is not going to be an easy task. Having is a complex job in this world. However, I can say it aloud and clear that I am determined enough to continue life, may it be at present and in the future. Swami Vivekananda said that my hope of future lies in the youth of character, intelligent, renouncing all the services of others and obedient good to themselves and country at large. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I am Nisi Kartika and I am from 11th standard C-section. No one has the rights to rule me. No one has the right to decide my future. And I myself doesn't have any rights to blame anyone that he or she has grabbed my future. My future is my responsibility, and I am very much pleasured to speak about this topic today. Life. Life is really a wonderful thing. Nature has granted each and every one of us with a single life. This is my life, and I must only make it better if I want it. No one else can do it for me. The future which is present in our life is like a golden opportunity. For example, take the future as a baby. If once the baby misses the chance of coming out from the womb, then it misses the chance of viewing a beautiful sight of this running world. Likewise, future is also the same. If we miss the chance of cutting the examinations and deciding a stubborn future, it is difficult for us to do the same thing in a second attempt. Because in a second attempt, we feel depressed. There arises lots and lots of doubts in our mind. Even our neighbors used to discourage. They used to demotivate us. Even though if everything is correct, everything is going in a good manner, we will not have the same comfort what we had in the first attempt than the second attempt. Because in the first attempt, we will think Nate only, you know, JW only, you know, it is very easy, yeah, we can do it, it is what it is, a simple task for us. But after the result only, we will really understand that it is like a real enemy for us. So, will we be able to crack that? We will have lots and lots of confusions in our mind, right? So that's why we will not have the same comfort that we had in the first attempt and the second attempt. From this we can clearly understand that our future is a thing which needs immediate, which is need to be done immediately. That is, it needs an immediate care. And it also needs effort. Of course, it also needs effort. That is, future is a thing which needs immediate care, and it also needs care and effort. We must never ever feel discouraged in our life. We must be bold and strong and stiff enough to face all the challenges of our life. Yes, we must never think that we are waste. Like he or she can do great things. Yeah, we are like we are waste. We can't do anything. It's not like that. Each and every one in this world is unique. Is unique in their own talent, in their own feature. The only part of us to is to make our talent to reach the highest peak ever. If we reach our talent to the highest peak, definitely we will, our future will be very bright. Like the garden which is full of blossoming and sparkling brightly flowers. Our future will definitely be bright. We must always feel that we are all lucky to live. I'm lucky to live. That is, we are all lucky to live. Because lots and lots of people are dying outside. Many children have been kidnapped and they are murdered. Infants are killed. people who are younger or older than us are being dead due to lockdown, due to many reasons like deadly diseases, corona, etc. And problems which they are facing in their life. They commit to suicide. Yeah, problems. Problems can be cured by being happy. And happiness can be brought by deciding a good future. Especially from my point of view, I feel that dreams are the result of our, that is, future is the result of our dreams. If our dreams are good enough, if our dreams makes us rich enough, rich in the sense it doesn't only mean money. Rich means it must give us happiness. Happiness can be brought by many ways. Being happy in a good way is only important. So our dreams must give us a good way of happiness, and it must also build our character. So it must give a good way of happiness. It must build up our character, and then it must also give us enough money to lead a day-to-day life. We must lead a sophisticated and well advanced life. So dreams must give these things. Dreams can should not be chosen like everyone is choosing their dream path. So I can also choose that. No, it's not like that. And this dream has a great scope in future, so I can choose that. No. Dreams must be first loved. We must first love the dream, and then only we will really have the happiness. First we must like the dream, and then only we must, if we like the dream itself, we will be happy with the job and good. Then definitely it will make our future healthier as well as wealthier. And from my speech, I think that you all can understand that making our future dull as well as bright lies in our hands. Thus I conclude my speech by saying a quote which is written by me. If you get something, think that there is nothing better than that. But if you don't get something, think that there is something better than that is going to come to you. So always be positive and stay happy. Thank you.
Can my parents drink a glass of water for me? Will my friends drink for me during my exams? Can my cousin attend an interview for me? Well, not. I'm solely responsible for what I am, my future, and my actions. This is what I'm going to share with my future, my responsibility. Hello everyone, this is Venezuela of Class 11 E. Abraham Lincoln said that the best way to predict your future is to create it. To create a future, you should have responsibility towards it. Responsibility is accepting that you are the cause and the solution of the matter. When I was little, I don't have a lot of responsibility. But when I grow up, I understand that a lot of things depend on my thoughts, feelings, expressions, speaking and action. To create a better future of myself, I should be responsible in all levels like personal, environmental, etc. Personal level is the primary one. Personal level is the ability of a person to take care of oneself. As a student, I am responsible for attending my classes on time regularly, taking good care of students' properties, understanding parents' values, expectations and cultures, maintaining good attitude, etc. I should be responsible towards my emotions. How I respond to the good and bad things that happen around me is also my responsibility. Even though we may have clear goals, sometimes failure may happen. We should avoid getting back or frustrated and succeed by solving the problem. We should maintain a positive attitude of getting back on track and never repeat the mistake again. Third, I should have responsibility towards me and my society. I should be responsible towards my society as a youth and an energetic citizen. I should take steps to remove the evils such as illiteracy, adulteration, corruption, untouchability, child marriage, harassment of women, etc. It should be created in everyone as a spirit of social service. I am very proud and happy that our generation children are having much social responsibility. You must have heard that during the pandemic situation last year, most children donated their pocket money for children's relief funds. When it comes to an environment, as a global citizen and man, I should have responsibilities towards my Mother Earth. Mahatma Gandhi said that Earth provides enough to satisfy every man's need, but not every man's greed. Each and every organism rely on water for their living. We, the human beings, polluted the environment as much as possible. Even though we polluted the environment, if we are not concentrating on conserving our resources like water, then in the near future, water would be as expensive as petrol. We must reduce our own carbon footprint through eco-friendly activities. I may conclude that a better responsible person will make his future good. Likewise, the future of our nation depends on 180 million students. The independence should also be used and safeguarded in a good manner. Thank you for providing this wonderful opportunity. So,
good morning to my respected teachers and my dear friends. I am S. Aishwarya from 12th year. My register number is 1308039. Now, I am here to speak on the topic, My Future, My Responsibility. As I explore to learn, I know that I need to take full responsibility in my actions. I need to be sensitive and have to determine the good decisions in my life. I hope to find the best me, a better version of myself. I saw many who are living their parents' dream, but are they really happy? Not at all. I remember Charles Kettering's words, who once said, "My interest is in the future because I am going to spend the rest of my life there." As your own. Constant changes and evolutions in our life, I wish we need to be self-aware in the future. Someone who is so confident, fulfilled enough and stronger than before to conquer the realities in the life. As great things begins from inside, personal transformation comes from inside. In order to achieve personal effectiveness, one must be committed and be able to think a long-term perspective. The road to become a positive, self-aware and value-driven person is not always easy. It needs a lot of commitment and hard work. Success is not always straight. There is a curve called failure. There is a loop called confusion. There are a lot of speed breakers called bad friends and of course red light called enemies. But there is a flip side. There are caution lights called family. There is a green light called good friends. And there is an insurance called aim. So success is very easy. Moving forward, I know it's not going to be an easy task. Living in this world is a complex job. However, I can say it loud and clear that I am determined to conquer life, maybe in the present or in the future. Thank you.
Good morning to one and all. I am Subhashini from Policy. As you are aware, of course, the speech is about my future, my responsibility. Before starting the speech, I would like to remember the words of Charles Kettering, who said, "My interest is in the future because I am going to spend the rest of my life there." What type of future we wish to live in is the single most important question facing by our country, even the entire world. Nowadays, there is a blaming game in parent-children relationship that children shift their future plan to parents and they are taking the whole relationship of their children. But actually, it doesn't work. We as a student, as well as our children, must take responsibility of our future by the aid of our past experiences and getting knowledge through various resources. But some may not believe in shaping one's own future, but it can be done. As the Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam said, "You cannot change your future, you can change your habits, and surely your habits will change your future." And we know habits are definitely our responsibility, and so our future, my life, is according to my decisions, actions, attributes, and attitude. I am currently learning from experiences. I am also aware that I play a great responsibility in forming myself. As I explore to learn, I know that I need to take full responsibility in my actions. I need to be sensitive enough to know when I cross the borders of morality and immorality. I must take the good decisions in my life. Now I like to recall the words of our great leader, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. "There is no wine if grapes are not crushed. There will be no perfume if flowers are not crushed. So don't be afraid if there are